Hi, good morning, sir. How are you?
Good. How about yourself today?
Not too bad. How can I help you?
I'd like a box of the Ashton VHD Illusion, please.
Sure, absolutely. Coming right up. How's your day going today?
Not bad. It's a little rainy outside, but not too bad.
All right, sir. That'd be $363.66.
How much is that?
$363.66.
Why is that so expensive? I, you know, get it out of Pennsylvania. It's like $100-something cheaper a box.
Well, sir, you know, here in New York State, we actually have a 75% tobacco tax.
You're kidding me, right?
No, I'm not.
All right, New York State will be the most expensive place in the country to be a smoker now that lawmakers have passed a new tax on tobacco products.
I am so sick of what is happening to mom and pop shops.
I was born into the cigar business. This is my passion, this is my livelihood. We've been here since 1964, Bella Concha. We never once ever thought about leaving the state of New York. Why? Because this is where it all started. This is where the retail side of my family's contribution to tobacco started here on 6th Avenue. I've grown up here. My customers are here. So we're here in New York. We're here to stay. But we have to change the landscape. We have to change this horrendous environment where the government is just overtaxing us and putting tremendous pressure on us. Experience with Brad and David and the whole crew over at Gotham Government Relations has been an enlightening experience. It's been a very positive experience. They've been able to really get things done as we needed to get them done.
It's an attack on small business in this state. We're seeing it over and over again.
I don't sponsor a lot of bills, but what I do is I only take on bills, introduce bills that really are important to me and I believe have a measurable impact on the state. And you had approached me about a terrible thing with regard to small business, and these are these smoke shops that sell premium cigars. Well, I had subsequently learned after you taught me that certain taxes have what's called a negative elasticity. In other words, it has diminishing returns where you tax it so high that all you do is drive the business out of business. And in this case, you're not even driving the business out of New York. You're driving it into other states or, worse yet, onto the internet.
You talk about a cigar tax, 75% on a cigar. You know what? That would cost a box of cigars that cost $100. At the end of the day, would cost the consumer in the state of New York $247 for that same box of cigars. I will tell you that the more that the state taxes, the less money that it does get. You know, we talked about those cigars just to be for 1 second. We used to collect $25,000 just from one store for 3 months in 2009. We collected taxes from that one store. Do you know, because we drove the price of the tax up so high that we forced the people to the internet and to the Indian reservation, and for the same 3 months a year later, we only collected $6,000, and that's with putting an additional 75% tax on the cigar.
I represent cigar shops throughout the city and state of New York, these fine establishments that adults go into, no kids go into, these high-end premium cigar shops. And what you've done is gone on a mission to destroy these legitimate businesses. Main Street USA,
Why would they be hurt, though? I don't understand. They can't go to the park or the beach.
Because nobody could smoke their products in New York City anymore.
They can walk.
It's unbelievable what you've done. You've taken away by these high taxes and every single law that you come up with, you've ruined the sales of brick and mortar establishments in this state. You've brought the sales online. The online companies are doing terrific now because of all these great ideas coming from the government. You know what? You need to stay out of people's lives already.
closing my retail operation as of the end of the month.
I'll be out of a job myself. It's kind of odd being here at Scotty's store, but I think at this point, even though we're competitors, we both know that we're going to go down on this ship together.
You'll see that what we're saying here today won't just happen to these individuals, although this is the most outrageous, most extreme example. It's going to start happening to you too as business.
Hi, Senator, David Schwartz. I represent the New York Tobacconists Association. Senator, if you want to make an impact on the people of the state of New York, you could probably forget about 90% of everything that you heard in the last 6 hours. Well, anyone who knows anything about the cigarette market, or the cigar market for that matter, knows that 33% of New Yorkers overnight did not stop smoking.
Both Brad and David are very experienced lawyers, litigators. They know how to deal with people and can be very, very convincing. And I think the most significant characteristic is just really that determination to win for the client, no matter what it takes, whatever tool it needs. And they're unwilling to take no for an answer.
They are very persistent in what they do. And every client to them is the client. Now, I know that we're not the only client. We don't have many. But they make you feel, and they act like, you're their only client.
We represent 300 stores throughout the state of New York, and they are going out of business right now.
Your government, okay, have they helped your business, or have they hurt your business? So answer that question, then explain why.
They have crushed our business.
Bureaucratic crap. That's what I call it.
You look at what we have and what we're facing here in terms of the New York state deficit and the issues that we're facing. His government has unleashed an attack that we've never seen in our history before.
At the end of the day, they get the job done. And after all, that's the most important thing, is to get the job done. As a matter of fact, just this past June, we were able to, with the huge help from Gotham and Brad and David, to get the Senate bill, S-3410, passed in the Senate by a huge margin. I think it was 43-18. In favor of the dollar cap. We still have a lot of work to do, and it's a work in progress. But I feel very good that in 2012 we're going to do some amazing things together.